Hello everyone, today we are discussing about the layers of atmosphere. Of all environment, air is the simplest one and it occurs in a single phase called gas. And this atmosphere, it consists of various gases and that include different percentage of gases like nitrogen 78.1%, oxygen 20% approximately, argon approximately 1%, carbon dioxide 0.35%, and others including neon, helium, krypton, hydrogen, xenon, ozone, radon. All this together forms the atmosphere. In addition to various gases, dust and condensed vapor may also be found in air. And various layers can be recognized in the atmosphere up to a height of about 100 km. And the layer which is nearest to the earth is called troposphere. And the second one is stratosphere, third is mesosphere, then thermosphere. And there is a temperature variation in all the layers. And from this picture, it is visible that the temperature in the troposphere gets decreases in height. That is, depending on altitude, the temperature decreases. And it also reaches near minus 50 degrees Celsius at the top of troposphere. And this is the layer where human beings and other organisms can live better, because where the temperature is good for the growth of any organism. And here the aeroplane all move at the top of this layer. Okay, and the area between troposphere and stratosphere is called tropopause. That is, there is a boundary in between every layer, and the boundary between the troposphere and the stratosphere is called tropopause. Okay, and this troposphere, that is the lowest and the thinnest layer of our atmosphere, and the height varies depending on the area. For example, it is approximately 16 km height in the case of equator region, whereas it will be less for there will be 8 km at poles, and this depends on season also. And the mass is 90% of total atmospheric mass lies in this troposphere, because it consists of large amount of water molecules or water vapor, and that provides the mass. And the temperature decreases 6 degrees Celsius per kilometer. Okay, and all the weather occurs in this layer, and also smog can be seen in highly populated area that may even lead to many kind of accidents. And water cycle also occurs in this layer. And the next layer is stratosphere, and that extends from 10 kilometers to 50 kilometers above the ground, and this is less dense when comparing to first layer troposphere. Okay, and here also the temperature increases, but it is not getting above 0 degree Celsius. Okay, I'll show you the picture. That is, the temperature gets increased but not above 0 degree Celsius. Okay, and one of the special factor of this stratosphere is that it consists of the ozone layer. Ozone is the O3 special form of oxygen. It has the capacity to absorb UV radiation coming from the sun. Okay, and this is very important, and it is very protective to living organism, because it prevents the entry of UV radiation into the earth. Okay, so UV radiation has an effect on DNA. DNA is the genetic material, and it has the capacity to destroy DNA by forming thymine dimer or pyrimidine dimer in the nucleotides that will affect translation, transcription and even replication. So from this UV radiation, this ozone layer protect us. And this is the layer where jet aircraft and weather balloons all function, or their maximum operational altitude is this layer. And the boundary between stratosphere and next mesosphere is called stratopause. Okay. And the third layer is mesosphere. It is the middle layer. Okay. It extends to almost 50 to 90 kilometers height. Okay. And here the gases are very less dense when comparing to all the other layers. Okay. And the content of oxygen is also very less. And the temperature decreases as increase in the height, and it decreases to very less, that is even to minus 100 degrees Celsius. And this is the coldest layer of atmosphere. Okay. And here the meteoroids come and burn up. Okay. And the next layer is thermosphere. And this is above mesosphere and extends to almost 600 kilometers high. And the temperature increases with altitude, and it may even reaches to 2000 degrees Celsius. And this thermosphere may be again classified into ionosphere and exosphere. And the lowest thermosphere, or the lower part of thermosphere, is called ionosphere. Here the solar radiation very strongly involves. It absorbed by the few oxygen and hydrogen molecule, and that results in electrically charged gas molecules, that is ions, and that causes heat. So the heat is produced by the charged molecules present this in this layer. Okay, that's why the temperature is very high here, and has an important role in the wireless communication and also the broadcasting, because it reflects radio waves. And an important phenomenon called aurora that can be seen in this layer. Okay. The ionosphere layer surrounded by two magnetic belts, which are known as Van Allen belts. These belts play an important role in the scattering of harmful charged cosmic radiation, and that is the reason for the formation of this aurora phenomenon. Scattering of cosmic rays causes the occurrence of aurora, and this aurora formation can exist both in northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. In the case of northern hemisphere, it is called aurora borealis, can also be called as northern lights. In the case of southern hemisphere, it is called aurora australis, and that can be called as southern lights. Okay. And usually, or this experience can be seen only from Arctic or Antarctic regions, and very rarely from Canada, Greenland, or Finland, etc. And usually it is visible from poles. Next is exosphere. This is the outermost layer of thermosphere, and it extends beyond, that is infinity, and usually satellites orbits here. Atoms and molecules escape into space here, and TV cell phone signals travel to satellites in this layer. Okay, so that's all about atmospheric layers, and these layers are very important because we are learning about air microbiology. So we'll see in the next video. Thank you.